Hi, and welcome to Teaching Wisdom. So today I'm going to share with you a method on how to use your fingers to do addition. You'll be thinking, hey, don't everybody use their fingers to do addition at the start of when they first start off to learn addition or subtraction? Oh, well, yeah, but what happens is you notice a lot of times they do not have a standardized way to do it. So they will just say, okay, 1, 2, 3. So if we have like 4 plus 3, they go like 4, and then they like 1, 2, 3, 4 plus 3, and then later they start counting like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So so 4 plus 3 ends up being 6, and then they write 6, and then of course that's the wrong answer. So why is that so? It's because that way they actually have to do counting 2 times. So that ends up actually adding to their cognitive load, which makes it very difficult for students to actually do it, especially when they're new to addition. So what I propose, of course there are many other methods out there, and some of them can be quite complex, like the Abacus method and all those things. But what I propose is something that I have taught my students and I found it very useful to actually use. And here goes. What I propose is this. Okay, you have all your fingers down, facing downwards. And then the first, you'll see that this is 1. Now this looks very unconventional and awkward. Okay, and then 2 also is awkward. But once you reach 3, 4 and 5, this is actually very conventional already. We also have your 6, again conventional, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is a conventional way of saying numbers. So the only 2 numbers that are awkward are your number 1 and your number 2. But this is quite easy to understand. So next time, the moment you see 7, this will be 7, 8. Okay, when I say 3, this will be 3. Right, when you see this number of fingers out on my left hand, it's 5. Okay, and you'll notice that the fingers will start opening up from your left most. So it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so we've reached 10. What happens if you have to add and regroup? What happens when you have to add and regroup and more than 10? So what will we do? What I'll do is you quickly close my fingers and turn over. And now again, we follow the same convention. The fingers will come out from here. Okay? So my fingers will come out from here. This will be 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. None of this on the tens end is meant to be conventional, but what we have, what I've purposely done is I want to let them realize, let the person who's counting realize that this is not in your ones place, this is your tens place. So, and you notice again, it is always starting from the leftmost, opening up. Okay, so as when students first learn, they just need to learn this. So then after a while, they get used to it because it's like 5, 1. You know, this is 16. Like, all right, this is 13. You see 3 here, open up, 13. 17. 19. Right? So how then next, how do we do addition? How do we do addition? Okay, so if let's say we have 8 plus 7. So 8 plus 7, we choose use the bigger number first. 8 is bigger, so 8, we show 8, and then we start counting 7. So 1, 2, quickly close. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What do we have? 15. So that's your answer. 8 plus 7, 15. What about if you want to minus? What if I want to subtract? So if let's say the number is 16. 16 minus 7. 16 minus 7, you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then quickly turn over, open up. Okay, 7. 7. And what's this number? Immediately you should be able to tell me this is 9. Right, so there is no need for counting, there's no need for them to have to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, so this is 9. So this reduces the cognitive load by a lot. The next question is, hey, in that case, isn't that limited to just 10 place? You know, you cannot go up, you cannot add like 75 or 85 plus 9, that kind of number. How do you do it? Oh, quite simple. Let me get you get paper and I'll show you. So suppose we have to add a number like 64. Let me see.
64 plus
18. Okay? So if you have learned addition whereby you actually draw the line and then this is 1's place, this is 10's place, you will remember that we only add place by place. And that is why this will work. So for example, what you will see is that this is actually 8 plus 4. So between 4 and 8, okay, which one is the bigger number? We use 8. So we use show 8 first, 8, right? And then we want to add 4. So 1, 2, quickly turn over, 3, 4. So the answer is 12. 12. So this is actually 2 and regrouped 1. Alright, 2 regrouped 1. And in total, this is 1 plus 6 plus 1, you have 82. No regrouping required. So this is how it's done. What about when we do subtraction? If we were to do subtraction, let's say for example 72 and you minus away 5, or let's put it as 25. Okay, again, we know that this is 1s and 10s, right? And so we have 2. Now we know, because we know that we are subtracting, so what will happen is we should actually be showing, we should actually be using the tens place. So this is 12. This is 12. We assume that this is 12 because we need to regroup. 2 is not enough to minus 5, so we regroup, this will become 6, and this is now 12. And that is why we use 12. So 12 minus 5. So this is 12 minus 5. You get 1, 2, quickly turn over, 3, 4, 5. And this is 7. Excellent, 7. And this is 62. 6 minus 2, you get 4. 47. Then the question is, can this be used for even bigger number? Yes, because when we add or subtract, it's always within the place value. And each place value, it can only go up to 10, which is as much as your finger can go. So I give you an example here. Let's say, okay, we have 1,802 plus 2,491. Now, of course, if you look carefully, you will see that the numbers in the 1's place and the 10's place do not require regrouping. So 2 and 1, you get 3, 9. So, but it is at the 100's place where there is regrouping required, isn't it? So when there's regrouping required again, we use 8. 8 is, we use 8 to my plus 4. So 8 is like that. And you plus 4, and it goes 1, 2, quickly turn over, 3, 4. This is 12. 12 and plus 1. This is how you write 12. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 over here. Correct? Again. So which means wherever the regrouping is required, that is where you use your finger. Similarly, let's say if you want to do subtraction. Again, you have, let's say, 2802, 2 minus your 1944. Now, in this case, you have many places where there is regrouping that is required, whereby you have your 1's place, 10's place, 100's place even. So 2, of course, is not enough to minus 4. So we need to regroup. But again, from here, that's not enough. So we have to regroup from here. So this guy becomes the 7. and this becomes your 10. And from 10, this becomes 9, and this is 12. Okay, now I have enough. 12 to minus 4. Very good. So 12, how do we show 12 again? 12 is like that. So 12 minus 4 is 1, 2, 3, 3, 4. And the answer is 8. I don't even need to count. 8. So 9. 9, is that enough to minus 4? Yes. So there's no need to do. But if you want, you can still use finger. And to minus 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 5. 7 is enough to minus 9? Not enough. So we need to regroup over here. This is 1 and this is 17. 17, how do we show 17? 2. Like that. Okay, 17 minus 9 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And the answer is yes, very simple. 8. 1 minus 1, you get 0. So we don't write that down. So this is the answer. And that's why the finger counting method, that's why this finger mark counting method is very easy to understand. All the students have to do is to memorize, you know, I mean this, the 1 and 2 is awkward, 1, 2 is a little bit awkward, but after that 3, 4, 5, it's very conventional all the way, it's quite usually what most people will use. Then when it goes to tens, you just turn over and then you will find that it's the unconventional one already. So 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. But after a while, the students will within, I think, 15 minutes, they should be able to memorize all the fingers. Like if I were to show this, 18. If I were to show this, 16. It should be no problem, 13. All right, I hope you have learned something today from my video. But that's it. I'm not saying that this is the only way you can do this, but this is something that I found it to be very useful and simple to understand for my students and myself. So if you are struggling or if your students are struggling, do try this method. I guarantee you will find it very useful and easy to understand. So if you like this video, please remember to like it and, you know, subscribe to my channel. I promise I'll make even more useful content from here on. Alright, see ya!